The Hive tool is a beekeeper's right hand. They're incredibly important tools used by beekeepers around the world. They're essential to working a hive successfully. Almost all hive tools come with two basic components, the prying end and the scraping end. Now, there are many different styles of hive tools. They'll have many different functions. The standard hive tool usually also comes with a nail pull that you can use to grab a nail and rock it out. Why are hive tools necessary in the first place? Well, bees leave a hive, go out and collect plant saps and tree rosins, etc. They use those substances in a hive as a product that we call propolis. So they will glue their hive together. They glue the lid to the box, the frames to the box to the bottom. Everything in a hive is glued with propolis. So if you were just to work this colony with your hands, it would be very difficult to remove the hive lid. It would be very difficult to remove frames. And that's why the hive tool is so important. Now, this is the traditional hive tool that I would have grown up using. There are different iterations of hive tools. For example, this is a J-hook hive tool that of course has the prying end I mentioned. It's also got this particular end that I'll show you how to work when you use it in a hive. There are variations of that. You can see a sleeker type of J-hook hive tool. This is called the Italian hive tool. It's got a much sleeker prying end and a much smaller hook. I'll show you in this hive how to use all the different pieces of these hive tools. One thing I do want to mention, if you keep bees, you are going to lose hive tools. Now, I hate to say this because I'm going to have to knock on wood the moment I say it. This is the hive tool that I've been using since I was hired at the University of Florida in 2006. In my personal life, I still have the same hive tool that I got and kept bees with when I was 12 years old. It's still the tool I use. But for all the other beekeepers out there, you're going to lose hive tools. You're going to leave them on hives. You're going to bury them in your apiary. They're going to fall off the tailgate of your truck. So I always tell beekeepers, when you're starting in beekeeping, purchase 5, 6, 7 hive tools. Put one in your vehicle, put one in the apiary, put one in your little bucket that you carry with you to the apiary to have all the tools that you need. I think hive tools are so essential that we need to do what's necessary to take care of them. When I am working a hive, I tend to keep my hive tool in my back pocket. But today, there are lots of different things that you can use to secure your hive tool to the body. Just to show you one example, this is a little belt that you can purchase that has two magnets that will secure the hive tool to your side so you always know where it is when you work your hive. And there are many iterations of this sold by various beekeeping equipment and supply companies. So now that you know why hive tools are needed, and now that you know the basic components of a hive tool and some types of hive tools, come join me in this hive and I can show you how to use one correctly. I'm going to take the classic hive tool, go into this hive and show you how it works. Remember, it's got a prying end and a scraping end. This colony has been properly smoked, so I'm going to take the prying end and insert it between the lid of the hive and the box of the hive that I'm going to be prying that lid from. And it's really simple. You just do a small rocking motion. I don't aggressively push because that will pop up the lid quickly and might be too much motion for the bees. All I do is hold this open spot now with my left hand, use my hive tool to pry up the second side slowly. Now that I feel that it's loose, I can gently rock the lid up. If there were a super on this hive, I would do that similarly. I would simply slide my hive tool between the two boxes, the super above it and the brood chamber here, and pry it like so. Now, at this point, there are a couple things that you could do with your hive tool. If, for example, you did not want this burr comb here on top of the frames, you can use your hive tool to scrape that off, just in nice flowing motions. I don't like to do that when bees are covering the frame, so I would probably smoke these frames here just to get the bees away from it. You could also use the prying end to slide off that burr comb like what you see here. I don't typically see a reason to remove burr comb unless it's more than what should ordinarily be there, so in the case of this hive, I would leave it put. Now, I would use the prying part of the hive tool to go to the end of one frame and gently pop it loose. I'm just giving a small rocking motion. I do the same thing to the other side of that frame, a gentle rocking motion. Then, with the hive tool still in my hand, but tucked away nicely, I will grab that frame and pull it straight out. If the frame were somewhat difficult to remove, I would know that I didn't pry it sufficiently, so I would start that process over again. This end is not for use to pull out frames. It's a little cumbersome for that purpose. Instead, you use the prying end. Now, I do have a couple of other types of hive tools here that I will show you that you can effectively do the same thing. We'll start with the Italian hive tool, which is a little bit smaller and sleeker. And again, you use that prying end to get up under a frame. I would do the same thing on this side to get up under that frame. But it has an added feature that it has a nice little hook that you can slide down and turn and pull up gently like so. Similarly, the J-hook hive tool can be used on the prying end. Its prying end tends to be wider still than the traditional hive tool and certainly wider than the Italian hive tool. Or you can use this piece to grab underneath the frame. And if you notice on this J-hook hive tool, it's got this little ledge that goes on the frame beside the one you're taking out. That gives you the leverage to rock out that frame. So watch how I insert it here. Then I spin it until that ledge on the hive tool is on the neighboring frame. And then with a quick rock, I can pull this frame straight out of the nest. It's a really nice feature that a lot of people like. And as I will point out again, this one has a nail remover, this one has a nail remover, but otherwise they all function very similarly. Hive tools are remarkable tools in that they are very strong. Using a screwdriver or a butter knife or any other device to remove frames usually results in damaged frames. It usually results in bent screwdrivers or bent butter knives. Hive tools were built for the purpose of working in hives, and for that matter, they're remarkably cheap compared to a lot of the other costs associated with keeping bees. So I really like having many different hive tools scattered around the place, and I hope you've enjoyed this video with me showing you how to use them correctly.